Grand Prix, a French term that refers to a series of important international races for very fast and powerful cars. Back in 1904, the International Association of Recognized Automobile Clubs, sheesh, that was a mouthful, was founded in Paris on the 20th of June. The association was designed to represent the interests of motor car users, as well as monitor the rapidly growing world of motorsports. In 1922, the AIACR delegated the organization of automobile racing to the International Sports Commission, or CSI, which would set the regulations for international Grand Prix racing. As motor racing returned after the Second World War, the AIACR was renamed to the governing body we all know and love today, the FIA. Now, there are only two Grand Prix in history that have run as an event of the Formula One World Championship in every single season, with those two being Italy and Britain. However, considering the French basically invented the thing, you'd think that they'd be a member of this select group of countries. Well, they would have been, but due to unfavorable financial circumstances, the race disappeared at the end of 2008. Magny-Cours, the circuit holding the race at the time, was said to have a huge makeover for 2009, but ended up being cancelled. So the race promoters started looking for alternatives. Rouen, Versailles, Sarcelles, Flins-les-Mureux. Bruh, they even tried Disneyland Paris resorts, but all of them were unavailable. The same happened in 2010 and 2011, but there was one that candidated itself for 2012. The circuit Paul Ricard. Fast forward another 4 years, it was confirmed that the French Grand Prix would return in 2018 at this circuit. So, how was it? It was okay. There was a bit of carnage at the starts, which forced two of the front-running cars to overtake their way through the field. But overall, it was a relatively processional race that didn't really have many highlights. Gotcha, bitch. However, if you thought at the time that that race was boring, you had no idea what you'd be in for a year later. The 2019 French Grand Prix was undoubtedly the deadest race of the season. Daniel Ricciardo, thankfully, was at least providing some form of entertainment, but ended up being handed two post-race time penalties, dropping him from P7 to P11, just to make things that much better. But why does this track produce such dull racing, and will it improve this weekend and for the future? The current generation of Formula One cars have always struggled with one major problem: following. These cars are highly sensitive to turbulent air and lose a lot of downforce in medium to high speed corners. It also causes the tires to wear at a faster rate, meaning that drivers will need to have a cool off period if they've been running close behind the car in front for too long. So Paul Ricard automatically becomes one of the worst tracks on the calendar, because it's jam-packed with exactly those types of corners. At the end of the 2019 race, Nico Hülkenberg explained that he basically spent an hour and a half sitting behind another car because the aero effect was too strong. His teammate Daniel Ricciardo also shared the same sentiments and added some comments about one of the few overtaking opportunities. For turn 8 at the end of the DRS zone, you brake so late that unless you're really kind of alongside or thereabouts, it's really hard to make a big lunge. This is coming from one of the best overtakers on the grid, mind you. So if he's saying it's difficult, then clearly there's something wrong. Another aspect of the circuit is its unique tarmac runoff. Unlike other tracks that either have grass or gravel, Paul Ricard features black, red and blue stripes of runoff, which are low grip and cause extreme tire wear. It doesn't really punish the drivers in the same way if they run wide or make a mistake. In fact, they don't just affect the tires, but us as viewers, who can literally get a migraine from just staring at the thing for 5 minutes. But probably the biggest reason why it doesn't produce great racing is simply because it wasn't built for that. In the 1990s, Paul Ricard was redesigned to become a dedicated testing facility for many motorsport series. It's a great place for testing the aerodynamic capabilities of a car similar to the Circuit de Catalunya. But the problem with this is that the teams are able to gain a lot of data about the track from the sheer amount of laps they do, meaning they'll know it like the back of their hand. So when the teams arrive for the race weekend, they already know what setup works best, and it's pretty easy to predict who will have the advantage. Oh yeah, and one last thing. track limits. However, changes have been made. And by changes, I mean Turn 5 having more of a crest and part of the track being resurfaced to get rid of the bumps. Otherwise, it's pretty much stayed the same. Regardless, I'm optimistic about the prospect of this year's events more so than others. For one, there won't just be two drivers in the same team fighting for the win. Red Bull are coming off the back of two race wins at tracks that favoured their car's characteristics. They are going to have a lot of momentum heading into the weekend and will be motivated to stop Mercedes from completely dominating. Sure, it will be tough considering what happened in Barcelona. Red Bull will probably struggle with their rear tyres, more so than their rivals again, given the circuit's more conventional nature. This weekend will also be the first one where the FIA will implement new wing flexibility measuring protocols. This means that Red Bull may not be permitted to run the same wing as they did in Spain if it doesn't pass the test. The midfield battle is likely where most of the excitement will lie, given it is the midfield. Hopefully we'll see some of the young guns like Charles and Lando get in and amongst the fight up front like they have been doing recently. Who knows? Maybe we'll see another surprise driver make an appearance on the podium, or we'll just get another Ham Verbot. In my opinion, I think one of the main reasons why this race has a reputation of being boring was influenced by the fact that the start of 2019 was already super uncompetitive. In the last 7 races, Mercedes had won every single one, albeit thanks to some bad fortune for Leclerc in Bahrain and Vettel in Canada. However, for the most part, they comfortably had the best car on the grid. When we got to round 8 for the French Grand Prix and it turned out how it did, that was the final nail in the coffin for most F1 fans. The season was pretty much deemed a wrap and Formula 1 received a lot of criticism for producing a less than entertaining spectacle. But if you ask me, I think it's unfair to judge it after just 2 races there. 2018 was alright. Wasn't great, but it also wasn't bad. It was just okay. 2019, though, was definitely a stinker. But since then, we haven't had any other year to make a judgment on it. Personally, I feel more people should give it another chance. Baku didn't produce the most exciting race the first time around, but look at how it's redeemed itself since. This year's Spanish Grand Prix was very intriguing due to the strategic battle between the top 2 teams. So all hope isn't lost for Paul Ricard. These track changes could provide an absolute classic, and fan opinions would change very quickly. Let's see how things pan out on Sunday, and then come back to this video to see if people still have the same sentiments. I hope you all enjoyed. Let me know if you think Paul Ricard is one of the worst F1 tracks on the calendar. Maybe suggest some improvements you'd make if you were the designer. Be sure to leave all your thoughts down in the comment section below. Please like this video if you enjoyed. Share it around with your friends or others within the F1 community, and subscribe to the channel with bell notifications to keep up to date with all the latest content and stories in the future. And as always, I'll see you in the next one.